Alright guys, good morning. Today is Friday, April 29th, I believe. I am headed to the gym this morning and I posted on my Snapchat yesterday that I was going to this particular gym. So there might be like some people showing up to meet me. Probably not. Likely not. I am going to, I just finished a coffee because that's what I'm still having for my pre-workout caffeine. But I do have some high volume with me. I brought it with me. Paradise Cooler flavor. I forgot the cotton candy, but this one's still really good. So this, if you haven't watched my PE Science Personal Faves product review video, go ahead and watch that. It explains what this stuff does. Essentially, it makes you have a better pump. Moving on to what's in my gallon jug here. I mix Ergonine Nanoberry and Amino IV Strawberry Breeze. This is a new flavor of Amino IV, and it's very good. Again, go watch that video if you haven't watched it already. It explains everything about the products that I've been taking. So we are going to, oh, forgot to tell you guys. I had my s'mores Icon Meals s'mores cake balls this morning for my pre-workout meal. My carbs are pretty low, so that took up like a lot of them, but it's my pre-workout meal, so it's fine. We're moving on to the gym in a minute. Let me get my shit together and there we can go. Does anyone else sit in their car for like a really long time before they go into the gym? Yep. All right, I'm gonna go in now. All right, so I'm at my friend's gym called the Top Strength Project. This is the logo. I'm pretty much here by myself right now. It's awesome in here. So we got lots of barbells, we got cardio, we got lots of racks. Pretty sick. Platforms. And there's a green screen. Awesome. So this is Steve, the owner of the Top Strength Project.
Hello.
He basically owns the gym so he can warm up wherever he wants and watch TV. We're watching Barbell Brigade on YouTube. I forgot to explain who Steve here is. He taught me how to lift, right? Would you
Amanda
say that's
was
correct?
One of my very first clients years and years ago.
I was like 15.
Yeah, I think you were 15 and I was like 18 or 19. I was doing an internship.
So 7 years later, here we are.
At Next Level in... We were in Scituate, right?
Yeah.
And she was one of my small group clients.
So my first experience into lifting was when I was terrible at sports in high school, and the gym that was in my town had a athlete training program for high school kids. So I would go to that, and they would teach us the trainers. So you guys were in college to be trainers?
Yeah, I was in college at BSU, and I was interning over at Next Level, and they'd write the programs, we'd take all the athletes through it.
Yeah.
And Amanda was my very best.
I was terrible. I didn't want to go ever. I'd be the lazy kid.
Yeah.
Who couldn't do anything because she had exercise-induced asthma. Okay.
Thank you.
just finished my lift. That was definitely a solid lift. I did just overhead press, shoulder stuff, squats, and then leg stuff. I haven't really talked about many prep struggles yet, but today I'm definitely feeling the prep struggles. A little bit tired, but that's to be expected when you're in a deficit. You're a little bit tired, but you can't let the tiredness or the fatigue or the irritability, which I don't really have yet. I'm okay still. I'm still kind of happy. You can't really let that get to you or affect your day. You just have to take it for what it is and move on with your day. Anytime that you're tired or feeling hungry or feeling irritable, if you let those emotions affect you and take control over your day, you're gonna have a shitty day. If you wake up and say, fuck, today's gonna be a bad day. I'm tired, I'm hungry, yada, yada, yada. I have a long day, I have a lot to do, I have a lot of responsibilities today, I don't get to do what I want to do today, and I'm just too damn tired to do anything, and I'm making excuse. It's gonna be a bad day. Like, if it's called the law of attraction, guys. So focus on everything that you want to happen that day. Actually put a smile on your face in the morning when you wake up, even if you don't feel like smiling. Simply the action of putting a smile on will automatically make you feel better. I like to journal, I like to write things down, I like to go for a walk, I like to take a few minutes in the morning to remind myself what is positive in my life, what I'm grateful for. Take a second to be grateful for whatever you have. I'm grateful to be here, to be able to work out, to be able to exercise, to be able to have access to food that's healthy, that's enjoyable, that I like. I'm happy that my body's healthy. There's so many things to be grateful for, so letting the little nitpicky things affect you, you're just causing yourself to have a bad day. You're just like, here's my bad day, let me take it. No, take the good day. Force yourself to have a good day. Another thing that I talked about on Snapchat last night really quickly, I discussed a couple of weeks into prep, is usually when people start quitting, or a couple of weeks into a diet, or a couple of weeks into a cut, or a couple of weeks into something that's a longer term goal. Usually people start quitting then, guys. So that's when you're working hard, you're doing more cardio, eating less calories, and you're not like seeing changes enough where you're motivated to keep killing it. So when you're like halfway through prep and you're really starting to see those physical changes, you're like, hell yes, I'm getting shredded, I'm feeling good, I'm actually making progress, the scale is moving, all of those things help keep you motivated to push and keep going. When you're 3 to 4 weeks in, one, two, three, 4 weeks in, you might not be seeing those physical changes 100% yet, so it makes it much more difficult to keep pushing through. At this point, usually people start quitting, so I said that if you start quitting now, then you're never going to get anywhere, and you really have to just trust the process. You have to trust that what you're doing is going to work. You have to trust your structured program. You have to trust your coach. You have to trust yourself to keep going, and that's when progress is going to happen. So I will leave you guys with that. I will catch you in the next clip. I'm going to go drive home. So thank you for listening to my rant. Daddy got 61, remember life, and then your life becomes a bigger one. I really like this song, and Lindsay hates it. I hope my children come to visit once a time. So much of soul, I'll be 60 years old. I think the world is cold. You like it. I have a lot of children who can go. Once I'll be 60 years old. Lindsay hates me for liking this song.
Mama told me, go make yourself some friends or you'll be lonely. Once I was 7 years old. Once I was 7 years old.
I was only 7 once too. Amazing. Lucas Graham
like
coming in at number
too.
3 on the high five at noon. In a 2, Fifth Harmony. Work from home on Bro FM.
And I delete no explanation.
We're pulling up to Target, and tomorrow is my friend Tyler's show. He's competing at the Jay Cutler Classic. I should probably get Elle's boyfriend Marcus something too. Anyway, I'm trying to get show day gifts. So if you have a friend competing in a bodybuilding competition, you have to get them something good for the day of the show. Tyler already has all of his food planned out, but I'm gonna get like Monster, Diet Mountain Dew, and some gum, and like something else fun. So we're gonna explore Target for a minute. Here we are. Should we get a... It's good? Okay. So what we got Tyler for show day gifts, he's gonna love this. So just a 4-pack of Monster and gum, because most competitors usually like can't have gum until the show day. A small pack of Oreos, but he'll probably eat them within the first night. And what else? Just some like Crystal Light and like little goodie bags and stuff, and then I think that was it. Oh, and then it's gonna go in this bag, and we're also gonna give him $100 gift card to bodybuilding.com because I have that and I have that to offer. But yeah, he's gonna like this stuff. So, and I got myself a Monster and like some new earphones and stuff. So yeah, okay, that's it. Thanks. All right, next stop on the list, we're going to my dad's cousin, who's our CPA. He did all my taxes this year, and my mom has done pretty much all of my financial planning for this whole entire year. Say hi, mom.
Hi.
This is my mom. She's my twin.
Nice to meet you all.
You met my sister, my actual twin, but this is my real twin. She watches all of my videos and she watches all my friends' videos, and she's on top of it. And she's taking me to go to a QuickBooks class. So I'm learning about how to organize QuickBooks so I can organize all of my finances, my taxes, my expenses, my bank accounts, and everything like that. So we're adulting today, so if you ever decide that you want to have your own business or you want to work for yourself, I highly recommend you get your taxes in order early. If you don't have a CPA or a lawyer or something like that, I highly recommend you go out and find someone who actually knows what they're doing. It is very, very worth it to pay someone or find someone who's a specialist, so you can stay organized. And legal stuff is very important, people. So be an adult, go figure that out. I'm going to figure it out right now, and I will not film it, but we're gonna check you guys after this. We just left the QuickBooks meeting. How'd it go, Mom?
Oh my gosh, very informational.
Very informational.
I think Amanda's gonna be taking over all of her own bookkeeping.
I'm basically hiring my mom to help with my bookkeeping for taxes, finances, everything like that. So like I said in the last clip, make sure you have all your shit together when you're doing your own thing and having an income from someone that's not the government, and you're not getting taxes taken out because you're doing things on your own. You have to keep track of all that. So we did that just now, and it took a long time. It's like, what, 5:30? We got there at 2. So it took a couple hours, but very, very, very important. This is a life lesson. If you get anything out of this video that I did today, aside from my workouts, this is a life lesson. Get your taxes in order and your finances and get it together. I am headed to the movies tonight with my dad and my sister, and we're gonna go see The Huntsman, the movie The Huntsman. I think it's Snow White? And I will check in with you guys in the next video. I'm probably just gonna go ahead and end this one here. So thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate you, and I'll catch you in the next video.